Hey, everybody, this is Larry. This is me going with Q2 of the recent bi-weekly contest 40 merch in between linked lists. So I don't think there is that much trickiness to this problem, to be honest. The tricky part is just implementation. In terms of algorithms, you know, if you have practice of linked lists, and if you haven't, I definitely recommend it because it does come up often on interviews. You just basically count a notes off, get that pointer, count B notes off, get that pointer, and then just kind of, you know, point things in the right way so that, you know, I know that I'm not explaining that well because I think there's no algorithmic complexity to this. It's just about implementation, right? So that said, keeping in mind that if you're watching from the future, that I solved this during the contest, and during a contest, what I optimize for is speed in terms of implementation speed. But also, of course, that it runs in time, so I'm not doing anything crazy. But given that n is 10 to the 4th, we have to do it in O of n time. But you can actually do it in O of n times in a number of ways. And one of my ways is just by what I call cheating. It is not in the spirit of things, definitely not in an interview. But if you look at my time, I solved it in 3 minutes, and that's my trade-off. So definitely would not recommend it during an interview. So before that, I'll show you. And I probably could have even put this in a helper function. But basically what I did is, okay, I take list one, I convert this to an array. I take list two, I convert this to an array. That's basically what this does. And I do cheating here. And then I do literally an array splicing or slicing or splicing, depending on how you want to say it, to another array. You know, we literally just removed from between A and B. This is very Pythonic syntax. You could have just done a for loop and that would be the same as well. Check that it's not with an A or B. And then I, you know, this creates another array, which I convert back to a linked list by just creating the linked list one node at a time. So again, definitely not recommend this, but remember that this is my context. But that said, this is still linear time. You could do it, and I obviously use linear space because I have to convert it to an array, but you can actually upsolve this, or maybe just normal solving it instead of down solving it like I did with cheating. You can normally solve this just by keeping references or pointers, and you can definitely do it. You just have to be really careful. And the reason why I did this cheating method is because I knew that it's hard to be careful with respect to edge cases, so I did it this way so that I don't have to worry about edge cases, or at least fewer edge cases because I have a few. But yeah, let me know what you think. Is linear time, linear space, because we look at each node a couple of times. For each node in linked list once, we look at it once. We look at it a second time here, and then we look at it a third time here. So O of 1 for each node in both list 1 and list 2. So total, it's going to be O of n time. Let me know what you think. It is definitely not the recommended solution. Definitely watch another video from someone else if you wanted to do that. I just wanted to explain my solution. Let me know what you think. Let me know if this is clever for you or this is dumb for you. And you can watch me solve it live during the contest. Next. This is annoying. Should have wrote a function, but once, right? Nope. Cheated. Hey everybody, yeah, thanks for watching. Let me know what you think. Ask me questions, because that's the only way I'm gonna know how to answer them in the future. Hit the like button, hit the subscribe button, join me on Discord, and I will see y'all next problem. Bye bye.